a senior partner with the law firm of Levin Papantonio Rafferty. Mike Papantonio has received numerous multi-million dollar verdicts on behalf of victims of corporate malfeasance. Mr. Papantonio is a board-certified civil trial lawyer by the Florida Bar and the National Board of Trial Advocacy. He is a fellow in the International Academy of Trial Lawyers and the International Society of Barristers. He is a member of the National Trial Lawyers, past president, in fact, American Board of Trial Advocates, the American Association for Justice, the Southern Trial Lawyers Association, and the Florida Justice Association, where he served on the board of directors for 5 years. Mr. Papantonio is one of the few living attorneys inducted into the Trial Lawyer Hall of Fame. He was awarded the Compassionate Gladiator Award from the Florida Justice Association in 2017. Mr. Papantonio and the firm's C8 trial team helped secure a $920 million settlement against DuPont related to the company's West Virginia plant discharging the chemical PFOA C8 into the air and water around the Ohio River Valley and exposing citizens to the toxic Teflon chemical. In 1998, Mr. Papantonio teamed with Robert F. Kennedy Jr., the Hudson River Keepers, and Waterkeeper Alliance to establish a river keepers program in Northwest Florida known as the Emerald Coast Keepers Incorporated, a full-time organization that serves the community as a public advocate for the waterways of Northwest Florida. Now, coast keepers and river keepers are known for their willingness to take polluters to court. Mr. Papantonio is an author of 4 motivational books for lawyers and a series of legal thrillers. He is also the co-author of Air America, the Playbook, which was listed by the New York Times as a political bestseller. Mr. Papantonio is the host of the international television show America's Lawyer, where he provides in-depth investigations into major corporate and government corruption. He is also the founder and former host of the nationally syndicated radio program Ring of Fire, along with Robert F. Kennedy Jr. and Sam Sater. As a political commentator, he has frequently appeared on MSNBC, Free Speech TV, RT America Network, and Fox News. The recipient of this year's H.K. Matthews Legacy Award, Mr. Mike Papantonio.
First of all, I'd like to thank Sue Strom for that wonderful introduction. Thank you very much. A sustainable quality journey to justice is under threat every day. And that's what we've been talking about throughout this program. It's easy to convince ourselves that it's always some outside influence, some entity that's more powerful and more focused, more committed, that's the biggest threat to anything that looks like a long-term, unceasing path to the type of justice that all of us should have a right to expect in this community, or for that matter, the entire world. It's sometimes hard to come to terms with the truth that it's rarely some cabal of bad actors or some vague collection of sinister forces that pose the most tangible threat to a sustainable, well-directed path to meaningful justice. In fact, it's a little scary to grab a hold of and internalize the truth that one of the most tangible threats to developing a community that can be defined by a high quality of justice is when we forget, when we can't remember, we totally forget what it took for us to get even this far on that road towards living in a just world. When we stop talking, for example, about the relatively recent history that bigger than life characters like H.K. Matthews, who had dogs sicked on him and rocks and bottles aimed and thrown at his head. Matthews, who made himself a living, breathing target of hate to the benefit of our kids and our grandkids. It's when we forget that. It's when we stop reading books that shake us and cajole us into imagining the abject fear and the horror that people like Martin Luther King lived every day from the very first day he declared war on racism and poverty. When we forget, the problem begins. Or when we stop demanding that our school system teach history that tells our children for maybe the first time that they've ever heard that 6 million mothers, fathers, sisters, and brothers were murdered in cold blood in places like Treblinka or Auschwitz because of a presence of incarnate, real, true-to-life evil and hate. And that kind of evil and hate never lies dormant. That tangible, real, palpable evil is always present, always with a mission to blockade all of us on our journey to justice. It's when we forget that we start losing the battle. As you go forward this week, take a minute. Ask a 10-year-old, or for that matter, ask a senior in high school about the Rosa Parks story. Ask them to explain to you everything they know about Pearl S. Buck, or Mahatma Gandhi, or even Nelson Mandela, and you'll be surprised. And it's my belief that you're going to come face to face with the most insidious threat to that sustainable journey to justice that we've been celebrating today. It's when we forget. It's when we start putting those types of things in back of our mind, we run the risk of losing this journey to justice. So God bless all of you, and please accept my most humble and sincere thanks and sincere gratitude for this remarkable award.
Well, I would say to him, it took guts to do it, first of all, in the time in which we live. For him to do that video at this time is a fitting tribute to what Fred Levin's legacy is all about. And I want to thank Mike for doing that video, because it really means a lot. And for him to even think enough to mention my name means a lot. Because I consider myself just a plain old country boy from Snow Hill, Alabama, Wilcox County, Alabama. Don't consider myself anything big, but I'm grateful because God has truly blessed me down through the years and has to a point elevated me to where I never thought I would be.